Oh, hi there. Well, a while ago I made a video about my low-tech stuff and my low-tech life and where my brand name comes from. It's basically based on criticism of people. There you old stuff. Okay, now it's my brand, Low-Tech Derek. Welcome. So, I'm in northern Italy. I just had a 400K run from southern France towards north of Milan. I'm stuck about 50Ks before Turin. On a lovely wintry day, well, sort of getting wintry. Beautiful place. It's the first serpentine of about six of them going across a hill. And here it is, my low-tech stuff, broken down for the second time in God knows how many years. So, while some people would say bummer, I say, well, it's probably the price you pay if you do have low-tech. You can fix it cheaply, but it may also break down on you. Now, let me fill you in on what we're looking at here. So this is just a bit of a scan on giving your first impression. Let's start with the really old stuff, myself. I'm from 1975. It's always my boat and my boat trailer. So they don't look too bad. Probably better than I do. Now the truck's from 1986. It's a Renault JK75, sold in the US as a Mack MS200. Now the Frenchies, they were more concerned about fuel consumption, so they basically came out with four cylinders built by Saviem. They've later been sold to MAN in terms of engine license, so today this is the four-cylinder block for MAN engines until the mid to late 90s. In French, I would say, ce n'est pas vraiment le grand foutre de guerre, hein? It doesn't really, rip the tarmac off when you accelerate, but hey, four cylinders, 100 horsepower on 10 tons for 1986, and for whatever I need, it's an economical, heavy-duty, low-tech way, so I wouldn't want to complain. So, while walking past it, you might have seen this engine block here. Now, this is a Perkins, also four-cylinder, that would have been compatible with my gearbox. That's engine number two. Funnily enough, it never ran, so I now have engine number three after 38 years of service of engine number one that completely blew. If you go through my blog, you might see a bit more insight on Derek's original project dating back to 2017 of me and my stuff moving to Canada. Now, obviously, I went through my moving blog as well, which I'll leave links to in the description. Say, okay, how do I move? Why do I move? And what am I gonna do? So the how is either with a bag of clothes or with the whole kit and caboodle. So obviously, I went online and put all my belongings you see here online. And nobody wanted them. And the ones who came past and said, yeah, I give you $20. Yeah, maybe $500. Hey, guys, we're looking at heavy-duty equipment here, but it's obviously not sexy. It's been working for decades, but, if nobody gives me the money I think it's worth, then, sorry, I'm gonna take it with me. I'm not gonna throw out, years of work of myself, part-time, obviously, of, keeping it all going, and then somebody, yeah, I'll give you $50 for it. So, nope. I'm gonna take it with me. And I had a quote done by Maersk, that was obviously pre-COVID, said, yeah, I can fit it all on a 40-foot flat or a platform with some outer gauge. And they quoted me $3,500 plus customs brokerage, either end. So I figured, well, for $5,000, it's worth it. Being able to being mobile from first day. Getting off the boat and say, okay, here it is. I got my workshop, I got my boat, I got my truck and everything, and I'm functioning. And I don't have to buy anything locally, which is again a hassle, etc. So, okay, I got organized, contacted all the authorities, and there you go. Out for work, the perfect plan. Summer in Canada, winter in the Caribbean. It never worked. Also, to that story, I'll leave links below. I don't want to get too long here, but just for the fun of it, the ideas were great, the concepts were really thought through, just didn't work. along came this pandemic thing, which I personally believe should be spelled plandemic, but that's a different story. And yeah, nothing really worked. And now the universe has opened the door saying, hey, we've got local work for you. And I just recently got a sponsorship in Canada, not at my place in Nova Scotia, but a bit further west, about 30 hours drive in Saskatchewan. So I'm really looking forward to that. The contract is meant to start pretty soon, early next year. It's obviously now October 2022. So I am getting organized. That's why I'm here, driving halfway across Europe with a broken down gearbox. Bummer. It's only a little thing, you know. Got to take it out and fix it soon. So I hopefully can find, actually, just as a parenthesis, is there a mechanic out there who can still do mechanical work? I mean, looking at it, you pull the gearbox out, you don't even need to take it completely out, you just strap it to the chassis, take it to bits, replace this axle, maybe you can weld the old one and put it back in. But that already seems to be too hard. I mean, the first guy I rang said, yeah, you'll need a new one. Yeah, it'll probably take 2 months. I said, guys, come on, mate. You're a mechanic. You know, I mean, I'm a professional trucker and seafarer. I'm pretty handy too, but I can't weld. I couldn't get into it, sorry. Can't be that hard a fix. Anyhow, I shall leave you with that. This is Low Tech for you. Brought you with love from Northern Italy on the Sunday break, because evilly, he always break down on the weekend.